Wherever the laws of any state are broken, a duly authorized organization swings into action. It may be called the state police, state troopers, militia, the rangers, or the highway patrol. These are the stories of the men whose training, skill, and courage have enforced and preserved our state laws. Common crime confronting law enforcement agencies is theft. To the prospective criminal, the field of robbery seems the easiest and the returns immediate. On April 15th of last year, a baffling series of robberies began. In each case, shipments of antibiotics and narcotics were removed from drug company trucks. For the first 3 days, the problem was without solution. The Highway Patrol had no idea exactly how or when the thefts took place.
Two on the 15th, one on the 16th, three on the 17th. What's going to happen on the 18th?
Somebody's got a real good thing going for himself.
Yeah, they sure have. $128,000, most of it in narcotics. How are they doing it?
Well, the trucks leave, they're locked. When they get to the delivery point, the locks have been opened, the stuff's gone.
Let me have the notes you got in the drivers, will you?
They're right here.
What about this guy? Says he pulled over to the side and then fell asleep.
Well, that's about the story. He got sleepy and pulled over, but he didn't check his load.
You don't knock over a truck without the driver knowing it. I don't think we're getting the whole story out of the drivers. Call the rest of these drivers in. I want to check them again.
Right.
Companies. See if the shipments arrived intact.
I get right on it.
Okay.
He drank every drop.
Has he pulled off?
Yes. Worked faster than usual this time. 20 minutes for him. The others averaged half an hour.
He probably didn't have any breakfast. It always works faster on an empty stomach.
Hey,
That's the last one. Now I got every single truck that's moving with drug shipments.
Have the units check these out.
We'll be able to check all these.
Do the best you can.
Set of units I dispatched. 2352 is picking up the Parkins pharmaceutical shipment at Willow Springs. 2120 has the Morgan drug truck at Calumet Bend.
Do me a favor, will you? Cross your fingers.
All right, 2580, stand by. We got another one. A Conroy drug truck, the one that left at 915. 2580 is with the driver now.
Now, what happened?
The driver stopped for breakfast, got a little sleepy, pulled over.
Sleeping sickness again. That's the second time.
When he came to, he checked the lock, found he'd been robbed.
I want to talk to the driver. Where is he?
He's 10 miles south of Pleasantville on 10. 2580, 2150 on his way, you're 1020. Hold the driver for interrogation. 10-4?
10-4.
Stay with it.
Looks like your car was parked right behind your truck.
There's only one thing that bothers me. I had plenty of sleep last night.
Truck. When it pulled out, it left marks, but not enough to get a print.
Okay, you can go. I'll talk to the driver.
Right.
All right, tell me the whole story. Don't skip anything.
Well, I left the plant about 9:15. Didn't stop for anything till that joint about 3 miles back. See, I didn't have any breakfast this morning. I slept right through the alarm clock.
What joint is this?
Lori's restaurant.
When did you begin to feel sleepy?
Well, I'm not sure. Maybe 5-10 minutes later.
Tell me, do you remember anything unusual before you went to sleep or when you woke up?
I remember I decided to pull off the road to keep out of trouble. Then I pulled a blank till I woke up. When I looked at my watch, I figured maybe I'd lost an hour to 45 minutes.
Why did you get out and check the lock?
Well, I didn't feel right by falling asleep like that and losing all that time. I was worried.
You figure falling asleep doesn't add up.
That's right. Why would I fall asleep?
Then you got something there. I want the highway patrol doctor to check you out. Feel well enough to drive?
Fine.
Okay, you follow me. We'll make it fast.
Our luck's holding up.
A couple more days like this and we'll retire.
Mother always told me to marry a smart fella.
You were double lucky. You married one that's smart and one that's good looking too. We live right. Here's our next pigeon.
Bill, what do we do if we run into one of these drivers a second time?
You drop him like poison. You've got the kind of a face a fella doesn't forget easy.
The Gibsons were on their way to rob the second truck on the 18th when Dr. Borden, after careful work in the lab, produced the first break in the case.
Well, that figures. What do you got for me?
We find traces of a very powerful soporific, enough to make anybody sleepy, effective in about half an hour. Now, all you've got to find out is how we got it.
Well, it's like I said, I slept late this morning. I didn't have a chance to eat anything at home. I rushed down to the plant, checked in, drove my rig out, and had breakfast at Laurie's.
You always go to Laurie's?
Hardly ever going out. I stop once in a while coming in.
You know the waitress?
No, she's a new gal. I never saw her before.
Anybody else in there?
Yeah, there was a couple in one of the booths and a truck driver at the counter.
Know him?
Oh, I've seen him around.
Anybody else?
Yeah, there was a girl. She was a...
Yeah, I know. I'm ahead of you already. She was a real pretty girl, and you tried to make some time.
That's about it. I came in, ordered breakfast. Then this doll came in, dressed real nice. She looked around the place, and then she smiled at me and sat down right next to me. Then the waitress came over and handed her a menu. When she reached for the menu, she knocked her purse on the floor.
And you turned out to be a big hero. You reached down to pick up the purse, and while you were doing that, she put a pill in your cup. Oh, brother, you've had it.
You could be right. Okay, so I'm a sucker for a big smile.
You and a lot of other guys. Hey, Johnson, come in here, will you? I think I got the whole setup now. Check with the other drivers. See if you can find a pretty girl who has a habit of dropping her purse in restaurants.
Right.
Thanks very much, Murray. I'll be in touch with you, huh?
Drivers admitted meeting a woman, and from the description each one of them gave, sounds like the same woman.
Oh, they got a good thing going. They're milking it dry.
They must know we're going to catch on.
Yeah, I know. That's why they're working so fast.
From what we know, we could expect a couple more jobs on Conroy trucks today.
I'm going to the Conroy plant. Tell them I'll be there in 10 minutes. Call them.
2469 to headquarters.
Headquarters by?
My 1020 is 5 miles due east of Dillon Junction. Another Conroy truck has been robbed.
This is 2150. What's the story?
The driver pulled over and fell asleep. Narcotics stolen.
Where was the driver before it happened?
A place called Jack's.
Ask the driver if he happened to run into a very pretty girl who dropped her purse.
Driver says he remembers the woman.
10-4. At least we know they're staying with Conroy trucks. Have the driver brought in for a checkup with Dr. Borden. I'm on my way.
2469.
Bill, let's quit now.
Don't be silly. We've still got time to hit a couple more Conroy trucks today.
But you said it wouldn't take the police long to catch on.
I figure it'll take them about a couple more days. Look, if you're worried, we'll make the day the last day. All right? What we've got here is worth at least 200 grand. We'll knock off for about a month and then move to some other part of the country. Give me that.
Look, Harry, I'll do anything to stop these robberies. Guards on the trucks might be the answer. All right, you hire the men. We'll have two men on every truck starting tomorrow. Right. Yes? Who?
Mr. Matthews.
Wonderful. Send him in. He's just the man I want to see. Glad to see you, Mr. Matthews.
How are you, Mr. Conroy? You know, I think we found a way to whip these robberies.
I certainly hope so. Two in one day is a little rich for my blood.
It's rich for anybody's blood. I want full cooperation.
Yes.
What time's your next truck leave?
Next one's out of here in 3 minutes.
Where's it headed?
On Route 14, out of state.
I'll tell you what, I'll drive it myself. Can you get me a cap and a jacket and a walkie-talkie?
Why, sure.
Thanks very much. Johnson, this is Matthews. I'm going to drive the Conroy truck myself. It's leaving in about three and a half minutes. It's going to be on Route 14 out of state. I'll stop at the restaurant, Junction 11 and 14. I want an undercover car. Keep it out of my way. If I run into the gal, I'll take the pill and try and get the job finished before I pass out, okay? Right.
Here you are.
Oh, good.
I've had the driver called in. You want me to bar with you?
No, you better stay right here. We might tip somebody off. Thanks very much.
I know you hated your job with that drug company, but it was worth it.
Yeah, it sure was. They taught me everything I know, and now it's beginning to pay off.
Headquarters.
Headquarters, Bob.
I'm leaving now.
I've got the units ready to pick you up. 2320 is headed for the restaurant.
We'll go through the whole routine. We need evidence. If I run into the woman, I'll drink the drug. Don't have the boys move in until they unload the truck. 10-4?
2810, 2150 passing your 1020.
10-4.
Warning 150 to headquarters.
Headquarters, by.
I've got company. A light gray four-door sedan.
2810 and 2935 just picked you up. 2714's in position at the restaurant. 10-4?
10-4. Headquarters.
Headquarters, bye.
I've had my vitamins. The girl's car looks empty. I think she's got help. Warn the boys to be careful. 10-4?
10-4.
Thank you.
50 to headquarters.
Headquarters, by?
I just pulled over. I'm not sleepy yet.
You started from 2810. You were right about the gray sedan. There were two people in it, a man and a woman.
Okay, I'm going to get rid of this radio. 10-4?
10-4.
That driver, he got out of the truck.
He's probably trying to clear his head.
He got back in again.
He'll go just like the rest. Don't worry, honey.
Remember next time, Bill, a guy that size takes two pills.
There's not going to be a next time. One pill is enough, believe me. See Highway Patrol next week. Until then, remember, leave your blood at the Red Cross or your community blood bank, not on the highway. This is Broderick Crawford saying, see you next week.